So now let's solve for the total power generated and the total power absorbed. So to get these values, we need to get the power of each component. So having these values, so let's put these values here. And these values, I1, and 2. 25 microamp here, I2 current to 25 microamp here, and V is equivalent to 22 volts. I'll start from left to right. So, power from the 5 volt source equivalent to, so the current I1 is going upwards, so it enters the negative sign of this current or main voltage source. So we have an equation based on the passive sign convention, so we have negative 5 times I1 is equivalent to 0.125 milliwatts. Negative 0.125 milliwatts. So next, we have this 54 kilo ohm resistor. So the power of the 54 kilo ohm resistor remember, in terms of current, the power in the resistor is just equivalent to I squared times R. 54k. We have 33.75 microwatts. Next, for this 1 volt voltage source, we have V only equivalent to negative 1 times I1. This is just equivalent to negative 25 microwatts. So the power across the 6K resistor is just equivalent to I2 squared times 6K. We have 3.604 milliwatts for this dependent source. So let's say the power of this dependent source, let's label this as 31. We have negative V times 30 I1. Negative V is just negative 2. We have 1.5 milliwatts. So this dependent source is absorbing power. So second to the last, we have this 1.8K. This one. So we have 30 I1 squared times 1.8 equivalent to 1.013 milliwatts. And lastly, is 8 volt solid source. Power across this. The power of this 8 volts voltage source is 28 times 30 by 1 equivalent to negative 6 milliwatts. Components here, this one and this one are supplying power. And the rest are absorbing power. In an ideal circuit, the power absorbed is just equivalent to the power supplied. Or if you add the total power, the power supplied plus the power absorbed is just equivalent to zero. So the total power supplied is, let's label this as PS, that's equivalent to P 5 volts plus P 1 volt P 8 volt. This is equivalent to 6.15 milliwatts. So the total power absorbed is negative. The total power absorbed is 4K plus 6K plus R of the dependent source plus power at 1.8K. This is equivalent to 6.15 volts. So in an ideal circuit or in an ideal scenario, power supplied is equivalent to the power absorbed. Now it's your turn to try and solve a problem. So for this problem, the current IA and IB in the circuit are 4 amperes and negative 2 amperes respectively. So find IG, the power dissipated in each resistor, VG, and show that the power delivered by the current source is equal to the power absorbed by all the other elements.